I think Denton's book was important because he was a legitimate biologist doing research who raised legitimate biological questions about whether a gradual, random mechanism could account for what we know to be the case in biology. So the problems that he pointed out in retrospect, I think, were not that hard to see, but that's the kind of thing that oftentimes escapes a community that all has a shared point of view. And all it takes sometimes is for one person to say, wait a second, if you look at it in this direction, then, you know, then our whole idea is suspect. That was, I think, Denton's greatest accomplishment. I found a number of people who said that it was precisely his questioning of Darwin's theory from a completely scientific point of view that opened their eyes and essentially allowed them to evaluate the evidence rather than just take people's word for it. And they also came to the conclusion that, you know, Darwin's mechanism was not a sufficient answer. He has accumulated even more evidence showing not only that the problems he pointed out back then are still unsolved, but they're exacerbated, that there are divisions between classes in nature that are not bridged by any of the innumerable intermediates that Darwin's theory requires. And he thinks that there's a what you would call a typological structure behind life. That is, there are just given structures that have no particular adaptive value but are embedded in nature. And it's a continuing and unanswered challenge to Darwin's theory.